Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Let's take a look at using transitions in iMovie. So I'm using iMovie 10 here, and I have a sample project where I've just dragged three clips into the project timeline. And you can see there are no transitions between them. There's just these black bars, which means going from one to the other, it's just quick snap transition right there. Nothing fancy about it. And I want to add some transitions to make a little smoother between these clips. So to bring up transitions, I go over here to the content library and I click on transitions. If you don't see this left sidebar, then you have to show it using this button up here. So the transitions appear here, and you could see kind of little previews of what they look like, and you can even scrub left and right and see this preview area here will show you to them. And if you want to use a transition, like say let's use the doorway transition right here, all you need to do is drag it and put it in between some of these. And you can see it actually both sides of this clip here. If I wanted it to go to only one, I'll undo, I can simply drag and drop it right in here like that, and then I could drag drop another type of transition here. And now I've got some more interesting colorful transitions between these clips. For instance, we can see what it looks like now to use this doorway transition between this one and this one. Now for more exact control over these, we can go into the Precision Editor. So let's select this transition here, and under Window we can go to Show Precision Editor. It's quicker if you do Command Slash. Now we can drag these clips left and right here to change where the transition occurs in each clip. In addition to that, we can even lengthen the duration of the transition. So now it's longer between it. And if we select the transition here, we can, we'll just double click and close it and select the transition, go to the Adjust menu here, and you can see how exactly how long the transition is for the swap. And then I could go and change it to say 4 seconds instead of six. As long as I go to less, and there's plenty of space here in this transition, extra space here and extra space here, I could go more as well. So for instance, you can see there's at least a second on either side. So if I were to close that up, I could go to 5 seconds. But if I try to go to 10 seconds, there's not enough video to cover. And you can see it just concatenates it to 8.4 seconds, the maximum it could go. And then I could go into the Precision Editor if I want and add more time to either side if I want to increase it. Now if you want to remove a transition, you can just select it and hit the Delete key on the keyboard. If you want to add a quick transition, one thing you can do is select the clip there, and then you can go to under the Edit menu to the Command T command there, which will add the default transition for the theme. And this theme is no theme. No theme for this movie here, so Cross Dissolve is going to be the default. I do Command T and you can see it adds it to both sides. If I were to select the end of a clip like that, just click on it and you see that little white line there, I could do Command T and you could see it adds exactly to the beginning but not to the end there. Now you can also make transitions automatic. Let's go to look at the movie properties, or just use Command J, go to Settings, and I could turn on automatic content. And one of the things that does is it adds the default transition for the theme, in this case the cross dissolve, to every spot a transition can go into. And now if we were to look at adding another clip in here, let's say it's at this one, and that would add to the end, it would add a transition there at the end. So you can just keep adding clips now and it will always use that default transition as long as you're using automatic content there. You can also set the default time for a transition here. It was set to 1 second before, and we can change that to something a little more if we wanted to, and then it would automatically, each new transition would be that. If you wanted to select all the transitions in a video, you could do that with Edit, and then you could do Select in Movie, and you can select transitions. You can see it selects all those transitions there, so I could do some adjustments with all the transitions now that are selected at once. So one more thing about transitions. I've gone in here to the project settings and I've changed the theme to Scrapbook. And when you use one of these specialized themes, you get a different set of transitions here at the top that are special for that theme. And I've applied one of them here. Now when I select it, you can see these little numbers here. It's because the transition uses all these different little still frames from the video to populate the transition. And here I've got exactly where it's taking those from. So if I want, I could adjust it so I can have the fourth part come from somewhere else and the sixth part come from somewhere else still. And it will eventually update, and you can see it updating right here to change which of these still frames are put inside of which of these photos. And several of the different themes have transitions like this. So when you select them and you see these numbers, that's what they are.